Hey there, thanks for checking out my project. I'm excited to show you how I built my electric hovercraft out of common materials, then to show you what makes it run, tell the quick story behind it, and of course include lots of footage of it actually working. So, I've always wanted to make a hovercraft I can actually ride, and since I'm an electrical engineer, I thought, why not make it electric? However, I didn't want to take forever to build it or have to order a ton of fancy stuff for it. So, I decided to make it out of things I could just get from Home Depot, then power it up with some common RC airplane parts I could order online to make it run. Lastly, I wanted to be able to build this in my basement and easily carry it outside, so I designed it to be personal size, being only about 6 feet long. So the first step was to make the body out of 2-inch structural foam insulation, cut to shape, and taped together. Hey, thanks for the help, kid. Then I started to add the cockpit out of plywood and to cover the entire structure in duct tape for strength. Lastly, the skirt was cut out of contractor trash bags and taped onto the body using carpet tape and duct tape. Overall, the construction was actually pretty simple, and it didn't require any special materials or tools, nor take very long to build. I was actually quite happy with the whole process. All right, so now that you know how it was made, let's talk about how it actually hovers and glides around. So the key to any hovercraft is to pump air underneath the craft and into the skirt to create a cushion of air. This allows it to glide around kind of like a giant air hockey puck. I accomplished this by using 4 90mm 1000-watt electric ducted fans. While it's true that these small ducted fans aren't as efficient as a larger fan, their compact size worked perfectly with this personal hovercraft. Also, they are actually quite powerful and provide more than enough lift to glide around nicely. Then, once you have the craft hovering on a cushion of air, you need thrust fans to propel you around. The main fan I used is a 28-inch prop driven by a 6,000-watt electric motor. This provides around 30 to 40 pounds of thrust and moves the craft around quite nicely. I'm personally hoping I can reach speeds of 30 to 35 miles an hour, but we'll confirm this later. Then, to assist control, I have 2 more of the same 90mm ducted fans mounted sideways to provide lateral thrust vectoring. These fans provide around 5 pounds of thrust each, and they actually assist the craft's rotation quite nicely. So then, to power it all, I use 2 sets of lithium batteries. The lift system is powered by 2 6-cell 10-amp-hour batteries in parallel. The thrust fan is powered by 2 6-cell 8-amp-hour batteries in series. Together, these batteries can give run times of about 10 to 15 minutes, depending on how I drive. So overall, there's actually quite a bit of power inside this small craft, and it glides around quite nicely. I just personally need to practice piloting a little more to fully enjoy the capability of this craft. So finally, why build an electric hovercraft? I mean, other than that it's totally cool, I actually had special personal motivation. You see, I had been trying to build a hovercraft since back in high school with my good friend. Unfortunately, at that time we couldn't even get the motor running. So it became a running joke between us, even making it into my best man's speech. So in college, I was motivated to try again and actually got a working hovercraft. However, it was a little too weak to ride and the motor got burnt out when I tried to ride it. So then a few years ago, I was like, I just need to actually do this and get it done and make a working hovercraft. Today, I'm claiming job well done on that challenge. Overall, I hope you enjoyed the story, and now just check out some more footage of the craft operating. Thanks for watching.